Hello, I'm Martin Fencka, and welcome to another part of Let's Play Civilization 5. The plan for today was to declare war on Rome and get rid of their city so that we could get into a better starting position for the war with Portugal. But as usual, I checked the situation before I started recording, and I missed one important thing. At some point, probably during the previous part, Portugal managed to get peace treaty with Rome, and they vassalized them, which means we want to declare on Rome, we have to declare on Portugal as well. And if we declare on Portugal, we will end up in war with Carthage, because they are also a vassal of Portugal. This means that once we declare, we'll be at war, or there will be war basically around the whole Mediterranean. And with the current military strength of Portugal, which is similar to ours, this will be a really, really interesting war. Now, this is the only way how we can move on, because I really don't want to leave Portugal move to South America. I'd really like to secure the whole Africa before we move to another continent. So yeah, we'll start this huge war, and hopefully we'll be able to handle it. I just hope that no one joins during the war. Russia is on our side. That would be one tough enemy, so hopefully no one will be able to bribe them. Not quite sure about Austria and Poland, but hopefully they'll keep each other busy and they'll ignore us so that we have enough time to get rid of Portugal. Before we declare, let's go quickly through all the pop-ups that we have. There's something interesting. Starving, but we should solve the starvation soon. Assur is growing. Let's lock all the tiles. Yeah, I think I'm fine with what we are working here. Just have to fix this farm again. More cities growing. Is there anything better than this farm? Maybe we can actually work the workshop. 34 turns compared to 20. Oh, that's a huge difference. Okay, never mind then. I'll just work the farm. I want to grow. Border growth. And Heliopolis. I think I'm fine working this style for now. But I will probably send the next archaeologist on this style, so maybe it's better to just maybe buy this style and work the forest. What's next? Oh, we got another unit conscripted, but I already promoted it, so we don't have to worry about it. Barbarians, not important. And this is surprising. Korea just entered the industrial era as the second civ. They have only 5 cities. I don't think they have more. Maybe. Oh, actually, they do have more. They have 2 cities down in Australia. Oh, and here are 2 more. I missed these cities. But it's really surprising. They're behind all the time, and suddenly they're the second civ to enter industrial era. So we'll have to do something about them as well at some point. Problem is that they are small and ahead of all their neighbors, so they probably won't be able to conquer too much, but no one will be able to conquer them because their military is probably significantly ahead of anyone who is around. And as long as they are small, it means they have cheap tanks, and Korea is a safe focus on tech, so they could start taking up pretty quickly. So we have another problem. But well, one thing at a time. I'll just keep an eye on them. First, you have to get rid of Portugal. Okay, buildings. What do we want to build here? How many specialists are we working? Not enough for a garden yet. 79 production. Not enough for the train station. I'll just go with Opera House, I think. Here we are done with hotel, and that means we can go into walls and castle so that we start getting the bonuses from Neuschwanstein. And that's it, now we can declare the war. Are we in position? Well, I hope that this is enough. Not sure that we have enough ships, but well, we'll see about that. Okay, so let's declare. Here are those vassals and no defensive pacts. Let's do it. Wandered some caravans, that's nice. By the way, do we want to get open borders from Austria and move around? Maybe it's not a bad idea to sneak some units through Alps and force them to basically split their army. Let's ask them. Open borders for 2 gold per turn. Yes, I'll take that. Maybe I could have gotten it for 1. I wasn't paying attention. Whatever. Not gonna kill us. Good thing is that we have our horses back from Rome, so we can build the agribusiness in our capital. So at least something. And now, where do we start? I think this looks like a good start. What can we hit? We can hit the spearmen. So let's do that. This should be a kill. And can we reach a retomb? 1, 2, 3. We should be able to reach them. Maybe it's better to first kill their ships, though. Can we one-shot this? We can't. What about now? Is it enough? That should be enough. Perfect. But it's not enough for the second kill. Well, actually, it was enough. How much damage can we do? Nothing, basically. So I'll just wait here. Or maybe we need the second ship here now when we killed all the naval units that were around a region. Probably not. Let's just move to the Mediterranean. This will be an easy kill, and I kind of want to get some vision around here. How far can we go? Just move back a bit. So I probably should block this passage so they can't send ships that would be able to attack our embarked units. Okay, this is blocked, but the bowman is quite annoying. I think I'll have to start attacking here. Oh, we can't hit them? Really? Wasn't there somewhere an artillery with extra range? I thought it was this one. Where is it, this one? Ah, it's this one. Well, good enough. Maybe you can start embarking here. Just have to stay out of range of the city. Okay. So, third army group. This shouldn't take long. You can move closer, get ready for the next turn. And another army. This is melee heavy, so I shouldn't move too fast. This citadel can be a problem. Just fortify, hopefully they will move towards us. And we'll just take Mediolanum from this side, hopefully they will just cancel the effect from the citadel. And some more units here. How much damage can we do to the city? Nothing. But what we could do, probably don't have extra range on our ranged units here. No, they're too low. I was thinking about attacking the city across the sea, but it's not gonna work. I'll just move north then. Okay, so let's end the turn, and this will be fun when all the units come out of the fog of war. Research agreement. Well, now we should be able to get at least something from this research agreement. The question is, do I want to help Korea? Because it's still a lot more for them. I'll pass. I'm not sure how long it's gonna take before we can get even close to Korea, so probably don't want them to grow too quickly. You want tea, but you have only one copy, so go away. Now, again, I have only one copy, so I'm not selling it yet. Until we get motherland calls, I'm not gonna sell any luxuries. You want sugar, though. We can sell sugar. Can't steal from Assyria, that's no surprise, but in case we can sabotage something or kill their great people, I'll let the spy work there. What do we have here? Probably cover two. Nothing really interesting happened. Where are all the units? Well, they have to be somewhere, because Portugal really didn't have a chance to lose the army. They won all their wars decisively. Okay. Just start attacking some cities. You can come closer. Do we have a range here? No, but it's the Gatling with the double shot. Let's park it on the hill. You can stay here and take those shots, that's fine, at least for now. Are we done with the railroad? I think we are, it just doesn't show the railroad yet. Okay, so let's just improve the hill. and you have to move back. Probably not gonna advance here, just gonna block their units. Can do a bit of damage. And move the Gatling closer so that we can shoot on the next turn. Oh, here are some units. And this is an easy kill. Cool. Oh, but wow, they have corvettes as well. I'll have to be careful with my ships because I kind of expected them to have quite a few ships, but I didn't expect them to have corvettes. So they will be pretty dangerous. Maybe it's not a bad idea to move one Gatling to the coast in case they send some more ships. And you will stay here. Okay, this should be enough for us to get the first city that we're gonna raise, and we're gonna resettle this as soon as possible because this ivory will give us monopoly for the luxury, so it's kind of important. You can heal. Come on, we are not done here yet. Look at all these citadels around here. It's gonna be a pain getting through that. Was a nice one shot. It's another kill. You can stay here. What is this? I want to upgrade this Tercio so that we have some units around Persepolis in case Persia decides to do something stupid. Maybe you can even use the Galias to do some damage here and there. It's obsolete, but well, maybe it's gonna be useful. We can probably get a village here. Okay, archaeologists. So that's another antiquity site, and here is another one. Oh, I hope that we'll be able to get through all these units. One, two, three, four, we can embark and then land right next to Kume. 1, 2, 3. Okay, embarking here would be a bad idea. I'm not sure if their cities already have range 3, and I don't want to risk it. Hmm. Seems that we are done for this turn. Yeah, this is the monopoly on ivory, because we now control this tile. That's pretty nice boost for such a small city. 6,000. It increased because we entered the modern era, so even small cities now will be a massive boost. This tile looks good. And anything interesting? Not really. Okay, buildings. We are done with lighthouse in Athens, so let's get, where is it? Harbor. 18 turns is a long time. But it's also a lot of food. Let's actually pay for it. Here we are done with walls, so let's get the castle. You are done with hotel. Now the question is it worth it building a train station here? How much coal do we have? 3 coal. And I would like to get a factory in the capital, which is minus 2 coal, so we have basically 1 coal left. So probably gonna wait. Just get a garden here. Should get a garden here as well. And train station into, well, let's get the hotel up and running. Okay, next. Problem is that we'll have to settle some cities with pioneers. Didn't want to settle any cities with them, but also didn't expect that we had to start war against Carthage already. Wanted to wait. Go away. I wanted to wait for colonists. Colonists are still like 70 turns away. Foreign diplomat in Zanzibar. I don't care about Zanzibar, so whatever. Maria declared war on Alexander. I have no idea why would she do that, but whatever. Okay, and here are those ships coming. So let's get the hell out of there. I think I'm gonna grab the visibility, it could be useful around here. First, you have to repair the ship, and we have a great admiral, but I'm not sure that I can safely get him anywhere where he's gonna be important. Maybe it's better to just use him for the voyage of discovery and get another luxury. Yeah, let's do that. Let's get the happiness, and we also can sell one copy. I think this gives us 2 copies. Yeah. There's gonna be also some extra gold. We should get, like, 2 more great admirals quite soon. It's not a big deal. Russia. Do you want 1 copy for 13 gold? I'll take that. Yeah, anything interesting? We have the connection between Athens and our capital, so losing the isolation unhappiness. We are up to 66. I just have to get rid of the crime. City growth. Yeah. work the forest. Okay, finally, the farm is ready. I'm gonna stop working the library, but we are still starving. Not that fast, but we still have the unhappiness from starvation, right? Yeah. I'm not sure that this farm will be enough. Oh well, we'll see. What can we do with this worker? Here we have quite a few tiles that need improving, so let's just send him through one of these forests. Oh, and our capital is growing, that's nice. What do we want to work now? Probably the windmill. Get all those great engineer points. We are on 114 turns. How much is it gonna be now? 83. And we have two more great engineer slots. Still gonna take a while to get another great engineer. At least another great engineer in the capital. But, well, at least it's the extra production. Okay, here we can get a mine. Can stay where you are, same here. I'll just land with as many units as possible. Oh, this is another kill that we can get. There are quite a few embarked units. I hope that we survive the damage from Carthage. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 units plus the city that can hit us. Maybe it wasn't such a good idea after all. Well, we'll see. Okay, buildings. Yeah, it's probably a really good idea to get the seaport here. Let's do it. And now we have coal only for the capital left, for the factory there. How many forests are we working? 4, but it's still... Okay, let's get the zoo. And now we can get back to our units. Why is this guy not moving? Come on. Oh, because there was a unit in the city, never mind. Here's a road that we don't need, so let's remove it. And this will be a really, really important unit. Where can we start attacking Mediolanum? This desert tile looks good. Okay. This will take longer than I expected. I thought that with the three Gatling guns around here, the city will be ours in like two turns. How much damage can you do? Nothing significant. So I'll just fortify. And here we'll just have to wait. Okay. Now which way do we want to go? We want to go north. Or if you want to get to Rome from north. Probably better to first make sure that we get rid of Rome. So let's go this way. Damn, too many units everywhere. Is this enough for a kill? It is, and I don't want to end the turn on this style, so let's just shoot. Ah, come on. I was hoping for a kill there. I'm just gonna heal 45. And you can. Come on, move, do something. Go. Okay, this guy's moving south to Kilimanjaro. Doesn't have the altitude training yet. So are we gonna lose our corvette or not? It's just crossbowmen around here, but it's quite a few units. Let's see. Now I think we survived. Still alive, still alive. Come on, you can do it. Good. Yeah, now we have the partisans spawning everywhere, which is a problem because of the stupid citadel. I'll just risk it. Should be able to kill both crossbowmen. There's one. Well, there's another one. And the citadel should do 30 damage plus some damage from units. Then we can pillage the citadel and this problem will be solved. And I hope with all the units that are coming to Mediolanum, they'll just Or they won't focus on just one unit. Okay. Or maybe I should go through all the pop-ups first. Do we have anything here that you would have to worry about? Or can we just ignore it now? I think we can ignore it. We don't have any naval trade routes. If they... Oh, actually. Maybe if they try to attack the city, it could be a problem with its strength. Can we get walls quickly? In like one turn, if we pay 1,000 gold for it. Same here. And same here. I didn't realize that they would be able to get so far, so that if they try something, you would be able to stop them here, but it seems that they have units everywhere. Really should fortify all these cities. Just get walls everywhere. We need them for those councils anyway. Just didn't expect that I would have to pay for walls. Okay, this is all fine. I hope this is enough. We should be able to protect the Mediterranean coast. Oh, do you want to work now? How much money do we have? 18,000. Yeah, it was all those walls that I just paid for. But I still think I'm gonna buy another forest. Oh, conscripted another unit. And why is it that we don't have any promotions? Because it's hidden behind the Gatling promotion. Okay, ranged, I mean, cover. And probably shock. Okay, Gatling, which one? Here. Can pillage without expanding movement. Not sure that's what I want. Let's get cover. Without range, we have to get close to cities. So it's probably a good idea to reduce the damage that we are taking. Or that we could be taking. Borica. No, I don't want to declare war. I want to sell you jade, and actually I should sell the ivory separately. We're gonna lose it in 10 turns. Oh, really? Oh, she's willing to pay 10. Just confused there for a second. Get armory, still some extra production. Opera house into castle, I think. You have your museum. How much culture are you producing? 49, that's quite decent. Maybe let's get the hotel before a castle here. And now we can get back to our units. Come on, shoot. Shoot. Like two turns and the city should be ours. Maybe I can just move back to our territory and heal. Let's get closer, at least for the division, and they have cannons as well. This war will be such a pain. Maybe I should just move in, take the damage, and pillage the citadel. But it's in the desert, so it's gonna take forever before we get there. If I move closer, that's 30 damage next turn, then we move on the citadel, but won't be able to pillage it, so that's another 30 damage. They have units around, so probably just lose a unit. Nah, it's not worth it. Let's just go a bit slower. And here are their musket men coming. Just do at least some damage. I have to be careful here, because this army has basically no experience, so we don't have the range, we don't have... Actually, we do have cover, so at least something. I'm not sure that we can take a city with strength 41, just with melee units, basically. Okay. This will be important. Can we hit the Rome from this style? 1, 2, 3, 4, and... This artillery has the extra range. So I'll just kill the unit. Don't have to care about Kuma. We gonna take it with just one hit from the artillery next turn. Can do some damage to Rome, or we can move closer to Rome. And also we can get some vision to the north now. Oh, no, bad idea. The citadel would do damage to the ship as well, I think. We can improve this style, even though it's out of range of mecha, it still should give us adjacency bonus, so let's do that. And now we are not starving, and we are also not growing, basically. So the starvation problem solved. Really like to get another village on the railroad, but if I get rid of this farm, we're gonna lose the adjacency bonus on this farm, on these farms, and the food here. So it's like -4 food for Mecca. But with all the sea tiles that we can work, it's maybe worth it. Villages on railroads are actually pretty good, so let's do that. Look at the difference. -3 food, but like everything else we get instead, so let's do it. Okay, you can stay here until the city is raised. You can probably stay here somewhere. And disembark the second artillery as well. You will fortify, and the corvette has to run. 2-4 This looks like a good tile where we can hide. Fortify. Okay, let's do one more turn. Oh, they're done with the archaeologist, or no, it's another one. This one just came here. So let's start working, but this another one should be done. Which one? This one. So what can we get? Ethiopian artifact or a landmark? It's too far away from all our cities. 1, 2, 3 So let's get the artifact. Yes, I'm sure. Katrina has made peace with Assyria. So what did she get from the war? Not much. Just one city, it seems. But hopefully she managed to get a good peace treaty, like gold pattern or something, to cripple Assyria. And how is it possible that she can have units inside Assyrian territory on the same turn that she got a peace treaty? Is it possible that she managed to vassalize them? Let's check that. Defensive pacts. No, they have no vassals. That's odd. I thought that all their units would be removed from the territory. Maybe it's a bug. Who's starving? Why are you starving again? I think we just solved it. Oh, because we are working this farm. That was a mistake. What are we working on? We are working on the grocer, so that's gonna solve the problem with the starvation, and now we'll have another decent tile for the city. Then that's something. It will be hard to get here in the middle of the desert, so it's probably fine. More units. Does it look like here? I think we can afford to send the unit back. You don't need more melee units. And again, our usual problem. Do we invest into really expensive forest tile, or do we just work a really, really crappy mountain? I think I'm gonna do it. We should get a lot of gold from this war, because Every time we capture a city, we should get a lot of money. And the same thing here, but this time these forests are really, really expensive. Not paying that. We can just work the forge. But Harar could probably use some good tiles, so let's buy the forest so we can improve it. And I'll probably reassign this tile. Okay. Ooh, and I forgot I wanted to build a train station in the Congo. We don't have enough food for this train station and the factory in the capital. And this would be a really nice train station with this production. And we are still not working on the mines. There will be some more forests. Damn. Well, I'll just build the bank now and I'll have to think about the train station. I'll have to decide if I want to get the factory in the capital or it'd be better to just get two more train stations and split the production a bit. Okay, council is done. Which means we can probably start working on another wonder here, and still no one wants Taj Mahal. That's interesting. I expected it gone a long time. Maybe I will try it even. This is one of the wonders that where it doesn't matter if it's in the capital or not, it doesn't give us any important multipliers for the capital. I have a feeling that Brazil is working on it, and I'm just gonna burn 10,000 for nothing. Or we can just go for something else, though the Golden Age would be really nice. I think it's too risky. Maybe I'm just gonna build some guilds here. You're not gonna work the specialist slots, but even without it, they still give some points. Now let's do that. More and more units. Come on, I'm not done around here yet. Is this enough to take the city? Let's attack, and I hope that the Corvette has enough damage now. Come on, you can do it. There we go. So let's raise the city. Expected more, to be honest, but still 2.3k gold is decent. And we should be able to take another city on this turn. Can we take Rome on this turn? No. can at least start doing some damage. Okay. Because I didn't expect Rome to go down so easily. Us moving units this way, but we don't need them here. There is a citadel, so maybe let's just move north then. Can we take Mediolanum on this turn? Probably can't, yeah, and look at the damage that we are taking around here. Oh, we can get there? How is that possible? Oh, because we can get there across the hill. Hmm. Okay, first of all, let's pillage the stupid citadel. I'm afraid that if I take the city, I'm gonna lose the unit that's gonna take it, so I was thinking about using one of these two. But I don't think I can do it that way. Oh. Let's see what's gonna happen. Yeah, they lost this citadel. That's gonna help a lot. We can raise the city. And how is it possible that we didn't get basically anything from it? Maybe because of its size. Okay, and because the citadel is ours now, it will be damage to their units if they stay around here. So I think they'll try to retreat as fast as possible. And we don't have to worry about moving units in. Come on, go away, workers. Sure that I want to move too close to the cannon. I'll just fortify here, and if the cannon comes closer, I'll probably retreat. Okay. Another tercio down. The Gatling can come closer. And here, I'd like to protect the city. Maybe we can just move closer to also make it a lot more difficult for them to retreat when we have a unit here. And how bad idea is it to attack? The attack is gonna heal us, and it's a guaranteed kill on the crossbowman. So as long as we don't get too close to Carthage, maybe. Oh, really? Thought it would be possible to go there this way. Never mind. Maybe this is too aggressive. This is definitely too aggressive now when I see all these tercios. But well. We have too many melee units anyway. Okay. Now this will be a problem. I don't think that we can do this. I'll just move both the Gatling guns to the coast so that we can hit their ships and retreat. Won't be able to take this without siege weapons or stronger support from ranged units. We can move back and can least pillage the tile and go back. Okay. You will have to wait. You will have to wait. And I think this is all for this turn. It was a good one. I managed to get like three cities. But look at all these units. Now we'll have to slow down. Maybe Rome won't be a problem, but everything else looks quite well protected. And even if we try to attack them from the north as well, I think they have enough units to defend themselves on all fronts. So in the next part, it'll be just about killing units most likely and trying to slowly progress. Maybe get rid of all these stupid citadels. But well, we'll see. I'll again check the situation off camera and maybe I'll come up with something to speed things up. But yeah, this part is over. So I hope that you liked it, that you can join me for the next one again. And until then, have a good time. Bye-bye.